Palm Beach, Florida, March 9th, 1995. Major League Baseball awards an expansion franchise to Jerry Colangelo and his partners. Arizona, at the time home to just 8 teams in the Cactus League, now has a big league ball club to call its own.
Here it is. Here's the Arizona.
Though it'll almost immediately be known as teal, the official team color is Arizona turquoise, a greenish-blue stone indigenous to the Grand Canyon State. Copper, because of its economic importance and history here, and purple, largely because, well, purple already had a pretty good following in Arizona.
We're kind of a purple family.
Bob Brenly wasn't the first Diamondback to wear number 15. It wasn't even Brent Brady. That distinction belongs to two-time All-Star Danny Manning. Arizona will have to wait another 4 years to see somebody 6'10" in a D-backs uniform. From the beginning, the Diamondbacks have a diverse set of uniforms that raise the ire of traditionalists. Just a month into their existence, Bill King, national writer for the Sports Business Journal, said that the team had rewritten the book on uniform combinations. There were 4 home jerseys, 3 jerseys worn on the road, 4 different caps, one of which was affectionately referred to by the players as their ice cream man look, and lasted only that 1 year. Maybe ice cream's a good metaphor, because the fans ate it up. On opening night, the team sold $750,000 in apparel. In subsequent years, the team streamlined its look. The inaugural snakehead patch was modified and found an extended home on the sleeve and on the batting practice caps. Some looks were retired, but more than anything, the purple and teal became synonymous with good baseball. From 1999 to 2002, only one National League team won more games than the sometimes black, sometimes pinstriped, sometimes purple Arizona Diamondbacks.
It's the game over! The game is over! Oh my God, can you believe this team?
In fall 2001, the bright lights of the World Series pitted baseball's nonconformists against the game's most iconic uniform. The New York Post's Tom Keegan repeatedly referred to the Diamondbacks' ugly purple logo or ugly purple pinstripes. What can you say? 7 games later, ugly purple looked awfully pretty on the world champs and on the 300,000 strong that greeted them in the victory parade. In the wild, a Diamondback rattlesnake sheds its skin 2 to 3 times a year. After 9 years, Arizona's baseball team was ready to do the same.
It was a difficult time, and I had just gotten here when the decision was being made to change the colors. But the reasons behind it were certainly understandable. You know, there was no red in our division. The Rockies were already purple. And we had complaints from Major League Baseball and others saying it's very difficult to match the purple, and it looks blue on TV. There were so many different reasons for at least looking into it. And it was a very, very huge and large task and a big transition for us.
You know, we're really excited about the change.
He's showing off the number 1 white home uniform with new script lettering featuring the new D-backs brand in Sonora red with black and Sonoran sand trim.
The team still had to win over a fan base reluctant to change, and they did.
Ball game!
Bob Melvin's young team had the best record in the National League.
There will be postseason baseball in the great state of Arizona in the year 2007.
To the 2007 Western Division champion Arizona Diamondbacks.
After 9 years in purple and teal, a new era had begun. But maybe more importantly, the die had been cast and the D-backs' evolution was underway.